Yes, everybody, very warm welcome to the session. I hope that all your preparations are going up high, and really I'm very happy to meet you all back in this series of session. Like we will see in detail like how an effective revision it can be made for your life science. Right, yes. So as far as the CSER NET examination is considered, seriously, this is one of the most important and challenging examination. Yes, absolutely. So this examination is considered as a very good exam, because overall, all over the world, not only in India, wherever you go and you go with a banner for their life science, yes, if you have cracked up the CSER NET, seriously, you are considered as the best student, right? Yeah, so this is how, let it be the companies, let it be any college or university, or you are going for a PDF also, yes? So they are going to mark yourself based upon, like you have cleared any kind of competitive exam. Really, that is going to be a great value for you, right? So this is Dr. Saranya. I am talking to you on how to make up your revision complete and strategically planned. Yes, if it is going to be well planned, almost you are done with the examination, right? Okay, so this is my profile, like how I am eligible to help you out in making your examination simple. So I did my PhD in biomaterials, of course, after cracking NET. I do have 10 years of research and teaching experience. So far I have guided so much of students for cracking up the examination. Right, so you can check out my publications at ResearchGate, and I work for an academy and I inspire more students to crack up their NET examination. I have come up with more courses that are really going to be helpful for you. Yes, okay, so you can see that this is going to be the total number of students who appear every year almost for your CSER examination. Yes. So overall, if you take the life science category alone, there is going to be around 1 lakh applicants, not 1 or 2. It is going to be the 1 lakh applicants, okay? So out of these 1 lakh applicants, right, how much of are selected? Yes, you can see that just 2000 are selected for JRF and 4000 are selected for LS. Okay, so this is how much of filtering it is being done for this examination. You might understand the fact that this is why this examination is pretty tough, right? Yes, but actually it is not tough if you plan it very easily. Oh yes, yeah, definitely, Shivani. Yes, right, definitely. So this is what, no? So last time, like, you are saying that you have qualified the LS. Now, you have to still more increase the cutoff to jump into this JRF, isn't it? Right, still more filtration is high, absolutely. So how to plan it? First, you should have a clear-cut idea on the target. Okay, fine. So how much is your target? So this is your first thing, isn't it? Right. So how you should fix your target? Absolutely, yeah, Shivani, I agree. Right, so based upon the category, so this was like your last year category, okay? Yes, so this was like your 2019 December cutoff value. Maybe this year it may go little bit up, yes, because you got a lot of time to prepare. That's why the cutoff may go up, maybe not greater than 60. Okay, right. So this last year it was like 54.5. Yes, Shivani, I agree. Yes, so it is going to be 54.5%. Okay, so for JRF last year, this year I am expecting approximately greater than 60% for sure. It may, as per me, it may go up to 145 plus also. Right, but let us see how is the difficulty level of the question paper, then only we can decide the cutoff value. But as of now, don't have anything in your mind, have a blank, yes, such that it is going to be pretty hopeful for you, right? Okay, so you erase this. Depending upon this, now it will be very premature to discuss the cutoff value, right? Okay, so coming back here, this is how, you know, you have to categorize your need. Okay, so based upon your target, you can seriously work on with your preparation. Like, yes, absolutely, yes, right. So last time, so these learnings you have to update yourself, right? So one of the comment, yeah, fine. Yes, Tashkar, definitely. Yes, Aarti. So what is the strategy in general you can follow? Okay, so this is for general. You can check out if at all your physical science, it's okay. You can check out the same method for your own category. Okay, right. So the first step to do is to look at the cutoff value. Okay, so as for this current exam is considered, you can have greater than 5 to 7%. Okay, so if the score is 54, you keep it minimum 60. Yes, right. So maximum you can go up to 65. Right. So I expect 145. Let us see how much it is coming. I expect more, but let us see how this is going to turn off. Okay, right. So if it is coming around 60 only, it is 120. If it is 65, it is going to be around 130 plus. For sure, for OC, it is greater than 140. And I expect 140 as the cutoff. Okay. So that is what I think in my mind. Let us see. So it may be 60 to 65, maximum 70, depending upon the difficulty level. So be prepared for everything. Okay, right. So this is the first homework that you have to do. So whatever cutoff you see for December, right? Last December 19, add a 10% to it. Okay, so if it is 54, keep your target as 65. If it is 47, keep it as 57. If it is 45, keep it as 55%. Got it, everybody? So this ideology of fixing the target is clear. Yes. Okay, so this is going to be the very first point. So the first point is to set the target score. Okay, so how to set the target score? Yes, so you can set the target score by keeping a 10 points greater, right? Okay, so that is how you can set up. I became black. Okay, so that is how you can set up a target score. So always this target score, it is going to be plus or minus 10%. Okay, fine. So while making up with the target score, yes, you should ensure that you select the units, right? Yes, this is playing a major role. Okay, yes, as far as this life science is considered, yes, yes, everybody, very good evening. So as far as the life science is considered, the non-skippable unit, yes, it includes ecology and evolution, maybe put together. I always club them together, right? Methods and molecular biology. Okay, so as far as life science is considered, these three are non-skippable unit. By chance you are not preparing this unit, it is okay. Whatever you have prepared for this month, yes, oh yes, Shivani, that's okay. So whatever you have prepared for this, you just write it. So if at all you are having in a mind to give up one more time, then maybe at that time you can select these units. So these are the non-skippable units. Yes, so what are the second category of it? Totally you have to do with the 8 unit strategy, minimum 8 unit to qualify JRF. The second grade of units include biochemistry, cell biology, developmental biology, yes, cell signaling, plant, yeah, animal, yes, what else, genetics, thank you Shivani, genetics, right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 has come, isn't it, what else we left, applied biology, yes, and this taxonomy. Okay, so these two are coming under the skippable units because very less marks come. But from this applied, you can do with little topics, like you can do this markers, you can do this fermentation, right? So these tidbits you can do such that you can make up a good score. Okay, so this is how you could have planned it already. So this part is already done. Yes, Absolutely. So now the thing that is in your mind is full revision only, isn't it? Yes, agrobacterium is there, markers are there, isn't it? Okay. Now coming to this revision part, one question I'm frequently getting from the students is that regarding the mock test. Okay, fine. So what students are saying to me is that whenever they are taking the mock test, they are getting only 50%. Yes, fine. Is it wrong? If a student is getting only 50% in a mock test, is it wrong? That should demotivate a student? Not at all. Okay, right. So what you should learn from the mock test? Okay, fine. Yes. Yeah, but number one, you should see the pattern of the exam. Okay, for example, if you take the CSER NET, yes, how many questions are there in total? You have 145 questions. Yes, out of that 145 questions, do you need to write everything? No, from 20 you will have to write 15. Yes, and in the part B you have 50. From that you have to write only 35, then 75 to 25. Okay, so in total, yes, how much is there? 4, 5, 75. Yes, only 75 questions you have to attend. Yes, in your mock test, do you have this many choices? Whichever mock test you are taking up. Yes, so do you have these many choices? Is it so? Is it the very same pattern that you are taking up the mock test? Maybe or may not be, isn't it? Right. So if it is going to be not the same pattern, okay, then you need not have any much worry. Okay. Why? Because your exam is going to have these apple of choices, isn't it? Right. But if at all you are taking up with your mock test, which is having a different pattern, number one, you need not worry. Okay, right. Number two, what to see in a mock test? Right. So how is the distribution of questions? Right. Okay. So how is the distribution of questions? So whichever mock test paper you are taking. Okay. So is it evenly distributed, or if it is going to be alike CSER NET? Yes. Same like how your CSER NET examination is taken. Like your CSER NET, you are going to have the same pattern of the questions, then absolutely it is important. Got it? If it is not going to have the CSER NET pattern, then you need not worry. Okay? Because it is not going to evaluate your skill. Right. Number three. Yes? Maybe. The units that you have left. Okay? Yes. It is coming more in the test. Has it happened? There is no poll in YouTube, or else I could have started that. Yes. So, if the units whichever you have left, has it come more in your exam? Is it so? Just analyze the question paper. Yes. If that is going to be the thing, then you have to be very serious. Yes. These two points are okay. You can forgive. Even if you get low mark also, forgive yourself, because the pattern is different, the distribution is different, that's why you didn't score. But if at all you are falling trap in this one, what is that? The units that you have left are coming more in the test. So what that it indicates? Yes, what is it indicating? You have left a unit, maybe, for instance, so you have left a unit, maybe you are not liking that unit much. Maybe this biochemistry you are not liking, but you found that out of 75 questions, yes, like greater than 5 or like 7 questions or 8 questions is coming from biochemistry. So what is the learning from this? Yes, what you can do is that if at all one unit is very much repeating, even in any kind of test, right? So don't skip that unit, okay? So at least to boost your morale, right, learn the important topics. Ex Diksha. So you can learn the important topics alone. Okay, for example, somebody was telling that you are quitting with developmental biology. It is absolutely fine to skip the developmental biology, but if at all you are taking a mock test and you feel little bit down that you have, you know, more questions coming up, don't give yourself a low esteem. You can boost your esteem. This is simply for you only. You can boost your esteem at least reading like 5 to 6 topics from it. Yes, this is for boosting your self-esteem. That's all, nothing more than that. Yes, whichever unit you feel that this is the unit, this is the culprit because of which you are getting low score in any kind of mock test repeatedly. Okay, you are taking like 10 tests and in all the 10 tests, you feel that, yes, like 5 to 7 questions are coming from this developmental biology or like 5 to 7 questions is coming from this biochemistry. Yes, sure, I'm going to tell it. So, but you are not able to do it because only of this unit, because of that your moral or boost has gone down. So don't do that. Okay, so shall we see some critical topics of developmental biology? Since because we started with that, I'll just tell you. Number one, yes, read about this cleavage and gastrulation. Okay, as well as yolk distribution. Okay, so this is definitely coming off every year. Okay, right, so this is point number one in different organism. Okay, fine. So the next thing that you can learn, it is the fertilization, right, as well as this fast as well as the slow blocks. Okay, right, yes, absolutely. So to practice the MCQ, what you can do is that you can begin with the PYQs of CSER NET, yes, and then you can go with the GATE, yes, and then you can under the GATE only you have the GATE XL, GATE BT, yes. So all those things, definitely round and round all those things are there, your DBT BET, yes. So almost the syllabus is same only. So these are where you can get up a variety of questions, JNU, yes, NII, IISc. So all these questions you can try up. Yes, absolutely. Got it. Okay, so fertilization, right? So fertilization, slow block and fast block. And then in this development, if you are able to study, you can study this development, at least the specification and induction. Okay, this is a very important topic. Yes, absolutely. Specification and induction and competence. Okay, right. Fine. Yes, Pooja. So the next topic that I will suggest you for final revision of developmental biology, it is that eye development, limb development, vulva development. Yes, so these are very important. And yes, and then ABC flowering pattern. Right? And then what else is coming to my mind is regeneration. Yes. And this time maybe new relation may come. Okay, new relation. Yes. And then this axis development. Axis development in Drosophila, Amphibia. Yes, that one. And yes, axis development, and then your Hawks concept. Okay, so at least these 10 topics, even though if you are not able to do for part C, it is okay. Okay, so if you have not yet read this developmental biology, at least read these topics for part B, because I find that yes, C. elegans vulva is here. Yes, vulva, C. elegans development. Yes, so all this development, if you are doing a detailed study, you go with everything. Yes, C. elegans, C. urchins, right? So all this development you can study. Yes, okay. So coming here, if at all you are not getting time to deal with the total unit, at least for part B, yes, do this snapshot summary. Where it is present? Snapshot summary. At the back of every unit in Gilbert, he has given this snapshot summary. Okay, right? So for these 10 topics, note it. Yes, and absolutely do it with a snapshot summary, at least if at all you have skipping this unit. Got it, everybody? Right? Likewise for every unit for biochemistry, if at all you are skipping the biochemistry, do a basic study on lipids, carbohydrates, protein, amino acid, right? So these things is, it is really helpful. Right. Yes, Pooja. How many units we have to prepare? Yes. So how many units? Yes, Aditya. So I recommend a minimum of 8 unit strategy. Okay. Right. 8 units we have to do. Yes. So I have categorized it into 3 sets. Okay. So must study, it is ecology and evolution, methods, right, and then mol bio. These 4, no choice, it is must study unit, okay, because it is high yielding. So I call it as must study. The second category includes all your other units, okay. The third category, it is applied biology and taxonomy. Okay, these are skippable units, but under applied, your markers and then transformation like agrobacterium, it is alone repeated, fermentation, these 3 are only repeated in applied. So if you study at least these topic, you are in this applied, right? And taxonomy, you can, yes. Oh yes, Pooja, it is okay, Pooja. So if you have prepared 5 units also, it is fine, but yes. You make sure that at least, fundamental it is your molecular biology, okay. So, at least you make sure that you read the tidbits in the other units, because part C you will not face any problem. Part C you will be through with the 5 unit strategy, right. But where you might find it difficult, it is the part B, okay. But I'll tell you that part B doesn't require an in-depth learning, okay. So, you have still 1 more month to go. Select any 3 units and do a partial reading, okay. So at least glossary you have to read, because with the 5 units, part B is very tough. Why? There is only total of 50 questions. Out of 50 you have to write 35. All the 35 you may not find it easy to select. Yes. So what you can do is that depending upon your cutoff value, yes, you will be jotting down. Right. So out of part B is very difficult. Why part B is difficult? It is to the point. Yes, you will have total of 50 questions. Based on the question paper, you have to write 35. But a minimum I am setting is 20 only. Okay. So out of the 50, if you have to go with 20 only, you will be able to do it. So let us take an example. Okay, fine. So I am giving you a very, very rough example. Just check out. Okay, fine. So there are 50 questions, right? So I have 13 units in hand, right? Yes, fine. So if I am taking unit 1, okay, yes. So unit 1, 3 questions are coming. Out of these 3 questions, right, 2 questions I know, 1 question I don't know, okay? So this is no. This is don't know. Okay, right. So I am just going to the next part of the question paper. That is unit 2. I have studied it very well, but to my bad luck, only 2 questions are coming. Okay, within the 2, only 1 I know, 1 I don't know. Right? Yes? Okay. So next, coming to this unit 3. In this unit 3, totally 5 questions are coming. I know all the 5. Right? Okay. So next, unit 4. Unit 5, right? So this I have a total of 4 questions, for instance, I'm telling you. Okay, so here I'm going to from unit 5 I'm having 3 questions, right? From unit 6 I have 3 questions, unit 7 I have 2 questions, okay? So unit 8 I have 4 questions, for instance, I'm telling you. Okay, so this is 10 14, 15, 16, 17, 20, 26 are there. Okay. Right. So here I have skipped this unit. Okay. So I may not know this. This unit, maybe if I am skipping, I am just telling you an example. Okay. Right. So this, maybe I am knowing it. Okay. So this, I am skipped it. Okay. Right. So this, I know only 2 I don't know. Okay. This is an example of how, it is coming off, in the examination. Okay, yes, fine. So now if you see, you know only these many questions. Yes, So out of like 26 questions, yes, so apart from leaving your unknown units, so these units you have never studied, so you will not take a risk. But among the known units only, not all the questions you know. You know certain don't know questions. Okay, this list is going to tell you the depth of your learning. Yes, absolutely. That's what I am telling. So what you have to do is that you just take an analysis. If at all you are taking a mock test or you just take up a CSER paper and just mark this unit, definitely this analysis will take you to next level. Yes, so you should learn from your mistakes. Okay, you should not keep on worrying that. Yes, you should not keep on worrying that no, you are not able to do. Spot out where you fail, then you can rectify the mistake. Okay, this is how you have to do. Just take a paper, whatever thing you have done, just just mark it off. Okay, so once you have marked it off, you will know that where you are lacking. Yes, for instance, if at all I didn't study this unit 3, what will happen? This could have become 0, this could have become 5. Yes, so it is a very dangerous unit to skip. If at all I have skipped this unit, it is the foolish thing that I have done. Got it? So I should not do this. This is what you have to sit and analyze yourself. Yes, maybe you take any CSIR previous year question, yes, maybe you take the oldest question or whichever question you are not so familiar with. Don't take a paper that you have solved already. Okay, so take a paper which is little bit far away, that you didn't know much questions from that paper, or you might take up the CSER model question papers that you have never seen, or enroll with us and any mock paper that you get. Yes, and see to that how your mistakes are done. Okay, so generally students, they come up with two kinds of mistakes. Okay, so I'll just spot it out, the mistakes for you. Number one is, number of unit is not enough. Okay, yes, number of unit is not optimal. For instance, you have 13 units, out of that you are going to go with the 5 unit strategy or 6 unit strategy. This 5 or 6 unit was absolutely fine 2 years back. Okay, so you can see that even my older videos, I will say that 5 to 6 years back is 5 to 6 units is optimum. That days have gone, right? So yes, since last 2 years, yes, absolutely. So from the last 2 years, you absolutely need 8 unit strategy. Yes, absolutely. Yes, Balamurugan. So we have it in the plus classes. Okay, right. So absolutely, you need an 8-unit strategy. Then only you will be able to reach the number of questions. Okay, fine. The second thing is, you are reading the 8 units, right? But you are leaving it in choice. Yes, for example, you selected biochemistry. Okay, but in this biochemistry, you don't like this PHN buffer. Okay, so you are skipping this PHN buffer. You are much worried about the numericals. You really don't want that stuff. Okay, so you are skipping that PHN buffer. But what happens in the exam? Yes, in the exam, what happens? From biochemistry, out of this 3 questions, 1 question is from PHN buffer. So what will happen? Your choice is going to decrease, isn't it? So this is what it happens in general. So what you can do to handle this problem? Yes? No, you cannot prepare everything. No, you don't like this one, right? So what you can do, that if you are leaving something in biochemistry, yes, this developmental biology, you didn't prepare, but what you do, at least read something and go. Yes, read some basics. Like, in the stem cells, what is pluripotent? What is totipotent? So if you read some what is cleavage and how this gastrulation is taking place. So the basic definitions. So all these basic things, tidbits you learn and go. Yes, maybe you can compensate the thing that is left off. Okay, so this you face even with the 8-unit strategy, right? So if at all you are doing with 5 units, then the scope of getting down is very more. Got it? Yes, with 8 units only you are feeling this much ups and downs, right? So that is why I am not recommending the 5-unit these days, right? So those days are gone. Now you definitely need a couple of more units to prepare. Yes, everybody? Okay, fine. So how to get motivated during the exams? You are reading a lot. I definitely know that everybody is reading like 8 hours a day. Yes, agreed, 100% agreed. Fine. But you might feel that you read this Monday. Yes, next Monday you just try to solve the same question. You solved a PYQ. Okay, so maybe in our practice session you just solve a PYQ. Yes, right. So the next Monday, the same PYQ you are just revising. Okay, maybe I am giving a retest or something I am giving in the class. Yes, absolutely. Yes, definitely, Padma. I'll give you. Yes, Priya. Right. So, you know, this PYQ, you are doing it on one day. Yes. So, after the 7th day, you are checking that you forgot the question. You remember that you solved that question, right? But you forgot that. Yes. So, you forgot that it is going to be gone. Happened? Yes. So, why this has happened? So there is a gap in this memory. Yes. So how to fill the gap? How to fill the gap? Yes. You have to revise. So should you revise the total thing? Yes. Maybe like I know you have attended a 10-hour lecture. Yes. So the total thing you should revise, or whichever you are not sure, that alone you should revise. I told you a technique. Yes, right. So whichever you are not sure, that alone you revise. Yes, absolutely. Yes. So so the reason may be like you know the answer, right? But no, you don't understand how this is correct. So this is where you need our help. Yes. So if you take any book, you will have the key. Like question number 100, the answer is A. The question number 111, right? The answer is B. But why this is correct and why all others are wrong, right? And where you have made a misunderstanding. So your misunderstanding could have been due to many options. Okay, so I'll tell you the options. You decide where you commonly make a mistake, right? Yes. Number one, hurried reading. Yes. So hurriedly you read. So this you must rectify. Because you have to slow down and read such that you will think. Okay, so I used to call it as three pass. That means every sentence you read 3 times in your mind such that you get the correct option. Yes, hurriedly don't read. Second one, right? So prejudice. Okay, this CSER will ask only tough questions. They will not give easy questions. So this easy option should not be there. So this is the toughest option. So this is the correct answer. Yes. Don't have it in your mind. Maybe CSER will give easy questions also. Okay. So, yeah, it happens to everybody. So, always listen to your intuition. I always say in my class. Yes. Yes, Priya. Listen to your, yes, Aarti is there. Yeah. So, listen to your intuition. Speak with your mind. Seriously, the mind is your best friend. Your brain will lead you the other way, but seriously, your heart will give you the best answer, right? So this has happened in our class many times. So people will think this is the correct answer, but later the brain will tell, no, no, it is not the correct one. Next, you change the option. At the time of poll, you give the wrong answer. Happened? Yes? Okay. So this you can overcome, right, by stopping this prejudice. How to develop this is an art. Okay, so this is an art and it is going to be a real skill, right? So how to develop this skill? You have to develop this skill only by practice. Okay, so take up more tests frequently. Yes, as many tests as possible, take it. Let it be your mock test, this test, that test, quiz, anything. You just try to take as much as possible. Yes. So give value to the intuition And practice to make, yes, practice is the best option. Practice to befriend your mind. If your mind is your friend, you can do wonders. Okay, right. Third one, it is the choice of question. Right? Yes. Don't always think that, especially for part B, I am telling this much why that is the major pit. Okay. So out of 50, you have to answer 35. So don't put this 35 in your mind. What will happen? It will lead to negative marking. Yes. Your score could have been 150. But due to this negative marking, it is gone to 120. Or it has gone to 100. Yes. Why? It is all because of the negative marking. So please don't select unwanted questions. Yes. Absolutely. Okay. Right. Yeah. The same thing happens to everybody. So that is all exam panic. Don't worry. Right. So your target is only 20 questions. I told you simply if you get 20 questions right, you are going to get 40 marks. Yes. So in part A, you did with only 7 questions, you get 14 marks. Part C is where there is not much choice for you. Got it, everybody? Yes? Yes. So here only you have to focus more. Sorry, 24 into 4, no? So it is 88. Here is where you have to focus more. This you will easily get through if you read well. Right? Yes? So don't see, if you logically see, out of 20, you want only 7. Right? And out of 50, you want only 20 questions. And out of 75 questions, you want 22. Is it achievable or not? Don't think this CSER number. Think of this number alone. Is it achievable or not? Out of 20, can't you take some 7 questions? Yes or no? If you have perfectly read, yes. Out of 50, it is definitely possible to go with 20 questions. Correct, everybody? So this is the confidence that you have to develop within yourself. So it will not come in a day. First, your mind should get convinced that you read well. That is the biggest ever thing, isn't it? First, your mind should believe that you have read. Right? Okay. So I was speaking about this mock test and all. Okay. So what you have to do? You have to go with the optimum number of unit. Right? And then, yes, you have to read, the other unit also, right? Because it has to compensate, right? Fine. And the next one, what I said, you have to practice because this prejudice and all you have to remove, and then you have to befriend your brain. Yes, right. And the fourth thing, it is the wise selection of questions. Okay, so this needs a lot of lot of thing. Okay, and fifth point, yes, confidence. Right? Yes, this is where the constant work plays a role. Okay, so what is this constant study plan? How is your graph? This is the month of Jan. Okay, this is Feb, this is March, this is August, this is September, this is November. Okay, right. So how it will be? In January it will peak, again it will go down. Again your application form comes now, so it will go up. Again it will come down. Again exam date, so it will go up. Yes, if this is going to be your graph, the same thing will happen with your memory also. True or false? Yes. If you are treating the examination like this, how will your memory work? Isn't it? Yes. December exam will be conducted or not? You have to think. You have to wait only. Yes. Oh, Subramaniam, don't worry. Okay. So you have to fix a constant study plan. Okay. Fine. Yes. So, why the confidence is not there? Okay, so you have to speak with yourself. We will find out today. Right? Okay, right. So why the confidence is not there? I'll tell the options. You are going to tell me which is true. Number one. Okay, fine. So the study material, okay, that you are studying, is it really fit enough to solve the CSER questions? This is the first one. Okay, yes. Oh, is it Thiru? Okay, nice, nice. Oh, Thiru, I didn't get the name, was new to me. Okay. Number one, yes, the study material that you are studying, is it fit to solve the CSER question? Okay, so this is the first question everybody should ask you. Okay, you just take up with any other PYQs. And just, map it, like whether this PYQ has the answer from your study material, right? Maybe your PPTs or it may be the PDF notes, whatever you are having, just check whether your PYQs are getting answered if at all you read through the study material. If yes, that stage is done. So your preparation is fine, okay? Fine. So the next one, yes, that you have to do a check, it is the practice. Okay, right. So under this practice, right, number one, you have to do this unit. Everything is stepwise. Like if you take a baby, how the baby grows, yes, immediately it will, after birth, the baby is going to write a poem in a school? Never. It is always the step-wise it does, isn't it? So first it will try to crawl, then it will try to stand, then it will walk, then it will run, and then only it will go to school. Likewise, always you have to practice step-wise. First, unit-wise you have to start. Okay, for example, you have read, like 7 units. Okay, so allot every day one unit. Okay, so maybe now the time is very less, no? So like you take one unit each day. Yes, maybe you have read developmental biology. You just take the developmental biology, okay? And first try to solve or try to go through the PYQs. Okay, so you will have the question bank with you. So go through the PYQs. So you will be familiar with the PYQs. Done. So this is with the CSER PYQ. Now, you can, I'll give you, you're a plus student, so don't worry, I'll give you the gate questions, okay? Or, some other questions of this developmental biology alone you have to focus, because this is the first step I told you, okay? So, take this developmental biology questions alone, maybe from gate or BET, a related topic, only developmental biology you take and you try to solve, yes? So, out of maybe just 10 questions I am taking, okay? Right. So, out of this 10 question, maybe you are right with 8. You are wrong with only 2, okay? So, you find out, right? So, which are the 2? Maybe, yes, you didn't read the question properly, right? So, this you have to rectify. If you didn't read the question properly, it is your mistake, obviously. So you have to develop that skill of reading the question properly. Maybe you didn't study the topic. Yes, that topic is pretty new, that is not covered. So you have to study the concept. You have to top up the concept. Okay, right. So maybe you have read something entirely, but you didn't read the new relation. Okay, new relation you have not covered. So, from that one question is coming. So, you have to study the new relation. Got it? So, where is the gap? It is due to the lack of reading, or it is due to the lack of your consumption, or it is due to the lack of revision. Yes? Or it is due to the lack of your study material. If it is going to be the lack of the study material or the concept, top it up. So that portion alone, you just make up an extra preparation for that concept, top it up, that's all, your problem is solved. Only it will come under these 4 categories, right? So what are the 4 categories? It is a reading mistake, that means in a error you read, you didn't see that not, you didn't see that it is incorrect, or no, you didn't have the patience to read, you just hurriedly made a wrong decision. It is a prejudice. So this is the at time of the test you made a mistake. Okay, so that you can rectify. The second category is you have studied but you didn't remember. Yes, you remember that on that day, you attended that class, right? But you didn't remember it. That means that this revision is lacking. Okay, so what you have to do? You have to revise it again and again to register in your mind. Okay, so first one eliminated, second one is eliminated. Third one, that concept itself you didn't study. I told you, like, you're getting a question on new relation. You didn't study new relation. So now you have to top up the concept. Yes, everybody, any question you take, you apply this method, definitely you will come out of it. True or false? Any other than this, any other thing is there in your paper? Either you should have not read it properly, or you have not studied it properly, or you have not touched it properly. Yes? So only three categories it is coming on to. Yes, everybody? So now you got the trick of how to understand, your performance in the test. Yes, absolutely. So this is how you have to come out of your mistake. Committing a mistake is absolutely fine. Everybody commits a mistake, right? So but how you are going to come out of the mistake? So that is where you have to learn, right? So map it up. Okay, if you map it up, then you will come and rectify your mistake. Yes? Okay, good, good. So this is how you can do. And absolutely, plan is crucial. And you have hardly 30 days. Right? Hardly 30 days. What is the date today? Today is already 18th, isn't it? So you have hardly 30 days. So these 30 days, you have to keep up your energy high. Yes, if you have some other disturbances, keep the disturbance away, right? So this 30 days is entirely for you. Make up the highest learning that you can do. Increase the power of your learning. Yes, study for 8 hours to 9 hours a day. You have 30 days. Calculate, 30 days you do 9 hours. What you will get? How much hours you get? Yes, 30 into 9, how much? Quick. 270 hours. Yes, this 270 hours is golden for you. Don't waste any more time. Yes, because so far you have learnt a lot, I agree. But what you are going to do in this last 30 days is what you remember for your final exam. Okay, so keep updating, keep reading, keep revising. Yes, and keep practicing. And keep analyzing why you lack in the practice. Yes? So you will try to implement, everybody in this session? Yes? Okay. Fine. Absolutely. So already could have made notes. Yes? So these notes you try to go through. Because these notes only will make your revision to be easy. Okay? So if at all your notes are not there, it is a little bit tough for you to revise. Yes? So maybe instead of notes, you might have all the PPTs. So just go through the PPT. I used to tell that, you just take up a PPT and see whatever you recollect or reflect from that PPT. Yes, if everything is remembering, it's okay. If you are not remembering, just revise that, redo that. Then only you will be able to get it. Yes? Okay. So the moment you see this diagram, what comes to your mind? The moment you see this diagram, what comes to your mind? It is nothing but your Ramachandran plot. Okay. Yes. Ramachandran plot for LL9. Yes. Oh, yes. Yeah, Shavari. Thank you. So if it is going to be this Ramachandran plot for LL9, what you remember? Which experiment did the Ramachandran use? So he used the X-ray diffraction. Like a story only, you have to recollect everything. So he used the X-ray diffraction. So what are the bond angles? It is going to be the pi angle, psi angle, and this omega angle. So this is a very rigid one. So this is going to be a flexible one. Yes. Next, you remember immediately about this Balara, isn't it? Yes, huh. So like that, for everything you are going to immediately remember all, right? Yes, so balara, right? And then no, you will remember that this is for LN9 dipeptide. If it is going to be for the DLN9, then it is going to come to the opposite direction, right? So if it is going to be for the beta turn, what is going to happen? So you have your type 1 and type 2 turn, right? So like that, everything you should remember by seeing this single pic. If it is coming to your mind, you have really studied it well. Got it? All the questions connected to that. Yes, so here this proline is present. So the structure is restricted. Proline cannot come here. So this is not a valid structure. Yes, but here glycine is present. So this is an unrestricted. So glycine can be present anywhere. Got it, everybody? Right? So you remember that your peptide bond is planar. You remember that this no pi angle. It is going to be your... what is this pi angle? It is between your C alpha and... what is your pi angle? What is your psi angle? Psi angle is C alpha and C. What is your pi angle? C alpha and N. What is your omega? It is going to be between C and... Right? So all these things, if you are able to recollecting, that means that you have studied really very well. Yes, you can give a applause to you. You can give a treat to you. Got it, guys? Yes? If not, it is okay. You just take out with this, sit and read again. Yes? So this is how you have to make up some slides, or maybe from our notes only, you can just take it up and top it up and see how is your learning power. Okay, so everybody, absolutely you have a power. Make use of this power. Yes, and definitely make use of your own strategy, right? So maybe whatever strategy I am telling is working fine for me. Yes, Ashavari, thank you. So like how it is going to be for you, you have to decide, right? Yes, so for the last 30 days, what is an apt timetable? Yes, so this is what many students were asking me. What is the apt timetable? For instance, I'm giving, okay? So you wake up maybe at 5 o'clock, maybe at 6 o'clock, maybe at 7 o'clock, maybe at 8 o'clock. So I'm not putting what time you are going to wake up, right? So I'm just putting at the first hour, okay? The first, I want total 9 hours from you all. Yes? So you are ready for this pledge of 9 hours study period? Yes, everybody in this session, I want a pledge of 9 hours study period for everybody of you. Yes? Okay. So the first hour of study, yes, the first 60 minutes, yes, you are going to study the toughest portion you really want to do. So, how to identify this tough portion? This can be an untouched portion. This can be a not remembered portion. Okay. How to identify this? Based on your practice test. Okay. So tonight you take a practice test. Okay. So that should be from your PYQ or anything, any question paper you take, do a practice test. Yes. Identify which is the tough portion for you. So let it be an untouched portion or let it be a not remembered portion. Take that portion, make a study for the first 60 minutes in the morning. Okay, right. Yes, have a break, whatever. So I had 9 hours, no. So 1 hour is gone. So I have 8 hours. Right. So next, yes, maybe for 10 to 11:30, you have a session with me. Okay, so this 90 minutes, you have my session. Okay, maybe for instance any educator session or whatever the coaching you are taking up or a kind of a learning you have or the revision you have completed. Okay, yes, so this is going to take up another 1.5 hour. Then immediately after this session is over, the following 30 minutes, make sure that you completely revise it for final time. No more you are going to take it back. Yes, because next you are going to the exam only directly. No more you are going to take it. So that is the 30 minute final revision. You can make it very fast. Whatever we completed in 90 minutes, you can condense and do it in the 30 minutes. Got it, guys? Because just now you have read with me, it is going to be very easy for you to finish it in 30 minutes. Right? So 2 hours gone, right? So this is the total 2 hour. This is 1 hour. So 3 hours gone out of my plan of 9 hours, right? Okay. Take some rest. Take some break. It's okay. Then again. So this is going to be the 4th hour. So 4th hour, you take a test. Yes, from this portion. Yes. So this is your developmental biology you are preparing. Take a test in developmental biology. 10 questions. Enough. So out of these 10 questions, how much you are able to solve and what is the mistake? Find it out, write it and keep it aside. Okay, so keep it aside. Write it and just keep it aside. Okay, right. So this you are going to do it for the next day, isn't it? So this is your target for the next day, right? So you have to analyze it, like how I said, how many questions you are able to do it, how many questions you are not able to do it. Why? Because you didn't remember, you didn't study, or the concept itself is new to you. If these are the two other category, not remember or untouched, next day morning you are going to study it. Yes. So 4 hours gone. Right. Again a break. Fine. So next, coming to the 5th hour. Yes. So next, this 5th hour is the same thing, like you attend one more class. Okay, so you are going to revise one more time with me. Right. So now 90 minutes is gone, another 30 minutes for the final revision, over. So another 2 hours gone. So now out of 9 hours, your 7 hours have gone. Yes, fine. So now you have the final 2 hours. Yes. So whatever you need, like I'm not revising now. For example, methods, we are not having time to revise now. Yes, follow the same strategy. Attend a recorded version of the methods. Yes, recorded version of the methods, and complete the 30 minutes of your final revision. Yes, such that you can make sure that unit is also complete. Now with this 9 hours of learning, yes, this methods that you are doing. Yes, and this is like your cell biology or whatever unit is that you are doing, and this is the ecology or your developmental biology, whatever unit it is done. So simultaneously you are doing the 3 units in a day. Got it? Yes. So 3 units you are completing in a day, right? By allocating 2 hours each. Okay, right. And then yes, so 3 twos are 6. And then, your test hours. So class, any test, mock test, any test you take 1 hour, right? So that becomes the 7th hour, yes? And one more 2 hours for, studying the tough concept, yes? And one more hour for the total revision. Got it, everybody? So this is how I suggest you to split up your hours. And yes, Rigved. So this is how you can split up your hours. Definitely you need a 9 hour every day for 30 days to make up your study complete and to make total revision. Yes, because you have a lot of things to remember. Yes, very recent unit you will remember very well, and the unit you have studied little bit 3 months back or 2 months back, you may not recollect. Okay, so don't do that mistake, and always have a fixed thing in your mind that you must crack this time. Yes, not to fear you, but I'll tell you that very soon the syllabus might change, because it has been greater than 10 years with the old syllabus. Last pattern of syllabus came by 2011. So just keep it in a corner of your mind. Maybe this 21, they may change. Okay, we don't know, like due to the situation and all, if it is there, well and good. If not, they may change. So always keep this alarm in your mind. So make these 30 upcoming days to be fruitful. 30 days is this in your hand to turn your life. Yes, right. So keep preparing, keep learning, keep revising. Definitely, I am always there with you. Right. So anything else, just write up to me. I will help you out. I will guide you. I am happy to do that. Yes. So this is my class schedule. Oh, yes. Good, everybody. So I'm just doing up this month, October only I started this. right? So in 12 days, I expect you to cover up with ecology. This is the schedule. Let it be my class or your own study plan. In 12 days, you can cover ecology like this schedule. Yes, evolution, you can do it in 7 days, right? Applied biology, 8 days. And your molecular biology in 10 days, right? Methods, you require 13 days, okay? And biochemistry, you require 15 days. So absolutely, you have to couple up everything together. Then only the total picture. It is like four pillars. You have to learn the concept, practice the MCQ, and know whatever mistakes you did in the MCQ, you have to apply and rectify the mistake. Then again, take up the mock test. So this is a circle, definitely CSR you can get. Yes? Okay, everybody. So these were the last time feedback that was given. Yes, Shivani. Absolutely. So this is the last time they were telling that scrolling was a big issue. The questions were lengthy and time management could not be done with the CBT mode. Okay? So all these things, you just keep it in your mind such that you don't get trapped into any of these. Right? Okay guys, so all the very best for your preparation. So all these courses are there for you. Yes, so I have the unit wise practice course, right? So you can enroll in unit wise as well as the total mock test also. I'm doing parallel revision in batch as well as the individual courses. So a lot of students have already cracked up with this. So why not you give a chance with this? Right, so this is for the final 1 month in 2100 and for 6 months, and this is for 12 months. If you are MSc, you go with the 12 to 4 month package. Yes, everything we have. Yes, so we have done with DBT, we have done with your CSER total courses, right? So this is for your CSER final revision batch. Yes. For 1 month, it is at the rate of 2100, right? So you can use my code Saranya Live, okay, where you will get a 10% off on the total fees. So don't wait, because I told you that only 30 days roughly it is in your hand. So every day is golden. So come on, start learning, shoot up your preparation. Yes, time is seriously running. It is not going to wait for anybody. Yes, you can learn at the earliest. Bye-bye all. Read smartly. Yes, take care. Have a good health. Yes? Okay, guys. Right. Okay, everybody. Take care and all the very best. I'll catch you up in another interesting session. Yes, everybody? Okay. Bye-bye all. Thank you. I hope that all your doubts are done. Yes? Okay. So, with confidence, with boost, you can go up for